Okay, so I was trying to make the yo-yo test and the beep test. This is going to be about back and forth acceleration for the phones or for any acceleration. Acceleration in the Unreal Engine would only go forwards on the x-axis. So, you know, you hit that. Okay, that goes. So you can see the flow is now going to the negative. So the float is turning negative, and then you can go backwards. I'll demonstrate it on a phone. This is just the blueprint action. So you get close. It's location-based. If you get close to that location, it uses a gate. I was just using branches at first, and if you use a branch, so I had acceleration only for some reason like gets values from both, because I was using a branch and it wouldn't go forwards or backwards because I had it in negative and positive. So I was like, okay, it's getting things from both. Then I tried it just negative. I tried to put in get acceleration, make it negative, so negate the float, make the float negative, and then I went backwards. And I was like, okay, that's the first time I've ever gone backwards with acceleration in the Unreal Engine. So it is possible. So it's like, okay, you need to toggle it with location. And then I had it in only branches with location. I was like, oh no. Because if it's only, if you don't have a sequence, if you don't have a gate and it's only branched, it will only go forwards in that location. If it's, and then if you get over there, it'll only go forwards, it'll only go backwards in that location. So I was like, okay, now I need a gate. So I made, you know, a gate at first, then I made two gates, then I was like, okay, this something has to enter here, you know, so then I put two more in for acceleration and it enters into the gate. So that way it wouldn't only work in a certain place, it would be open after a sequence. So this sequence, when you're at the starting line, this will hit that gate and open it, and then it will go to add movement input and it will go there. And you can go forwards. And then once you get to this place, 6110, which is where this pillar is, right there. Once your guy gets there, this gate will go, and it will close this gate, and it will open this gate and allow it to flow, and now you can go backwards. So there you go. It's you know, you have a toggle, get acceleration, return the X value. At first I was like, oh no, is location going to be found? Does get actor location apply the whole time? I thought you had to trigger it. No, get actor location and get acceleration, they're constantly being checked within the engine, which is good. I didn't know that, because a lot, like acceleration, you know, you got to babysit some of these things sometimes. This one, you did not have to do that. So yeah, that's, and then I'll put a demonstration up of it in action on the phone, maybe in a bigger space, maybe not. We'll see. So I'll put that demonstration up and show how it works. But yeah, just get actual location nearly equal to the float. You don't want it precise, because then if they get, you know, a little bit ways off or something, you know, you don't want something annoying happening where they don't make it or whatever. So just do nearly equal, two branches, two sequences, two gates, four outputs in the sequence for acceleration. Only x-axis values are used. Get acceleration for the x-axis. Oh, one thing, the acceleration, the positive acceleration, you do not need to for the scale value, goes into both. The positive x of the acceleration goes into both add movement inputs, because it'll make it negative anyways. You'll be going backwards. I don't even know if you'll go anywhere if you negate it. You might, but I'm not sure. I don't want to risk it. I don't feel like, you know, messing with it again. So, yeah, this is that in action. Then you can see, you know, with it all explained, see the gate's working, it's opened. It's not working in only one place, it's working the whole time. Boom. Hit this area. Then now we're down. Now you can see the main thing is the bottom one's open. So we're going to go back, and then the top one is going to be the top movement input at the far right of the blueprint is going to be opened. And there you go. And that way nothing catastrophic happens. They're not stuck moving, you know, backwards or forwards. They're just going one way, you know. And boom, now we're going the other way. It's pretty useful. And then that's the hardest part, was getting net backwards acceleration in the Unreal Engine. I was like, how do you do that? Because it can accelerate forwards. It's amazing in accelerating forwards. It's a beast for accelerating forwards. It is. It's the only engine that works with acceleration in phones and other things with accelerometers. It's the only one with the scale value and everything. The only one that works. And you couldn't go backwards. And now you can go backwards. So it's like, it's a big freaking deal. It's awesome. I love going backwards. I love going forwards. The other thing, like, I have to think, like,